Hello everyone, it's me, the groom. As you can see, I've pre-recorded my speech. I logged on the internet to try and find some inspiration because I didn't have a clue where to start. And I found lots and lots of cool stuff. I mean, lots of cool stuff. And then after a couple of hours, I actually realised I'd better actually do a speech. On behalf of my new wife and I would like to thank each and every one of you for sharing our special day with us, as I know a lot of you have travelled a long way to be with us, and we really appreciate that. It wouldn't be the same without you all here. It would have been cheaper, but definitely not the same. But in all seriousness, a few people do need a special mention that have gone the extra mile to be with us today. First off, my best man and his lovely wife Stina have travelled all the way from northern Norway to be with us. Secondly, Colin and Jan, who have travelled all the way from St. Lucia. And last but no means least, is the Machen family, who have travelled all the way over the Tamar, who we all know are only here for the free booze and the free grub. Unfortunately, it's not possible to have everyone that we love with us today. Even though they can't be with us, they're with us in our spirit, our hearts and our thoughts, and I know they're looking down on us proudly. I would now like you all, ladies and gentlemen, to join me in a toast to absent loved ones. There's an unwritten rule of wedding etiquette that no one should look more handsome than the groom, but I think it's safe to say my two nephews, Ollie and Max, have broken that rule and they're the best looking ushers I've ever seen. Next, I'd like to thank all of Sarah's bridesmaids. Sophie, Thea, Emma and Betsy. I think you all agree that they look absolutely beautiful today. A special mention must now go to Sarah's best friend and maid of honour, Emma, for all her help leading up to the wedding and her planning of the hen party. Judging by some of the photos, I think everyone enjoyed the hen do, particularly my sisters-in-laws with the party bus. And obviously, the live drawing. My personal highlight was being woken up at 4 a.m. by our good friend Jenny Lynch, who was rather tipsy, naked, to tell me she weed on her tail. I would now like to say a massive thank you to our good friend Moira for all her help leading up to the wedding and for a lovely reading during the ceremony today. It meant a lot to both of us to have one of our best friends say something so lovely. Next, I would like to thank my best men, my brother Simon and my best mate Chris, who I've known virtually my whole life, and I couldn't be more proud to have them both standing beside me today. The only slight drawback is they both live in this parallel universe where they create these fanciful stories which they truly do believe, and I thank you for humouring them during their speech. But as this is pre-recorded, I won't be thanking them for the stag do, as I don't quite know what they've both got in store for me.
Stop it.
We do that again.
One more time. I didn't get it. No, I didn't get that one. I didn't get it. You got to do it one more time.
To Rob and Joe, thank you for raising a beautiful, on a good day, intelligent, and most days stubborn daughter. And of course for letting me have a hand in marriage. We do both really appreciate everything you've done for us, along with Matthew and Vicky, Michael and Lolly, Tom and Julia, and Helen. You've all made me feel so welcome and part of the family from day one, and I'm very grateful to you all. I promise to love and protect Sarah. I love with all my heart, and hope today you've not lost a daughter, but gained an extra seat at the dinner table for me. Now to my mum and dad, to say thank you doesn't quite seem enough. You've put up with me for 29 years, and I'm the good son. Sarah and I really appreciate everything you've done for us. You've loved and supported me in everything I've done, and made sacrifices to give me the best possible start in life. I can honestly say I have the best parents in the world, and I hope I've made you proud, and I love you both so much. I would now like you all, ladies and gentlemen, to join me in a toast to the parents. Without their help, most of today wouldn't have been possible. This leads me to star of the day, my gorgeous new wife, Sarah. I think everyone will agree how stunning and beautiful she looks today. When thinking how best to describe my feelings to you now that we're married, I looked at a variety of sources for inspiration, but I kept coming back to the big man. The true light, my guiding spirit. He has a following of millions, Homer Simpson. When asked about marriage, this is how he responded.
It's like being married to my best friend, and he lets me feel his boobs.
I want everyone here to know how lucky I feel to be with Sarah today. Sarah's beautiful, intelligent, funny, caring. The list is endless, but unfortunately, I can't read your writing, darling. But seriously though, Sarah, I love you in so many ways, for so many different reasons. Because you know me and understand me like no one else ever could. Because you believe in my dreams and care about my feelings. You make me laugh so hard and I smile so often. Because you have a way of bringing out the very best in me. Because you're my best friend, my soulmate, and I love you with all my heart. Thank you for marrying me and making me the happiest man alive. And for loving me as much as I love you. And I know this is the start of many happy years together. So ladies and gentlemen, please be upstanding for probably the most important toast I'm ever likely to make. To my new wife, my absolute world, to Sarah. Before I hand you on to my best men, I've got one last surprise for my new wife.
What would I do without your smart mouth? Drawing me in and you kicking me out. You've got my head spinning, no kidding. I can't pin you down. What's going on in that beautiful mind? I'm on your magical mystery ride. And I'm so dizzy, don't know what hit me. But I'll be alright. My head's underwater, but I'm breathing fine. You're crazy and I'm out of my mind. Cause all of me loves all of you. Love your curves and all your edges, all your perfect imperfections. Give your all to me, I'll give my all to you. You're my end and my beginning. Even when I lose, I'm winning. Cause I give you all of me, and you give me all of you. Oh, how many times do I have to tell you? Even when you're crying, you're beautiful too. The world is beating you down. I'm around through every mood. You're my downfall, you're my muse. My worst distraction, my rhythm and blues. I can't stop singing, it's ringing in my head for you. My head's underwater, but I'm breathing fine. You're crazy and I'm out of my mind. Cause all of me loves all of you. Love your curves and all your edges, all your perfect imperfections. Give your all to me, I'll give my all to you. You're my end and my beginning. Even when I lose, I'm winning. Cause I give you all of me, and you give me all of you. Oh,
give me all of you. Cards on the table, we're both showing hearts, risking it all though it's hard. Cause all of me loves all of you. Love your curves and all your edges, all your perfect imperfections. Give your all to me, I'll give my all to you. You're my end and my beginning.
beginning. Even when I lose, I'm winning. Cause I give you all of me. And you give me all of you. I give you all of me. And you give me all of you.
Hello everyone, it's me, the groom. Oh bugger, what was I going to say now? Right, alright, as you go. As you can see, I've pre-recorded my speech. Oh, that's a good start as well, wasn't it? For my new wife and I, that was a very fake smile, wasn't it? Oh no, this is going to be a disaster. Wife and I, oh, it's such a fake smile, I can't smile without doing a fake stupid grin. This is a nightmare. On behalf of the... On behalf of... Oh no. On behalf of... On behalf of me... Oh no. To Rob and Joe, thank you for raising... This leads me to the star of this show. Hello, start there. That's quite wrong. Actually, I can't read the rest of your life. I've messed it up, didn't I? Yes. Important toast I'm ever likely to make. To my new wife. Oh. Almost had it then, on the last bit as well. What a dick. Right. Whew. God, that's done. There's no way I would ever read that out on a day. No chance.